In this video lecture, we will discuss about thin cylinders and change in volume of the thin cylinder due to an internal fluid pressure. Before going to discuss about these topics, first you should know about what are the classification of cylinders. In many engineering applications, cylinders are frequently used for transporting and storage of pressurized fluids. These fluids are maybe liquids or gases. So for example, boilers, air vessels, large pipes and etc. So these cylinders classified into two types depends on the diameter to thickness ratio. If the diameter to thickness ratio is greater than the 20, those cylinders are classified as thin cylinders. If the diameter to thickness ratio is less than 20, these cylinders are classified as thick cylinders. These walled pressure cylinders are closed containers that hold the pressurized fluids inside. In this case, the thickness of cylinder is very small compared to the diameter. So, when the cylinders are subjected to an internal fluid pressure, the stresses are developed in the cylindrical shell. Those stresses are called hoop stresses, longitudinal stresses and radial stresses. If a cylinder, whatever that it may be, thin cylinder or thick cylinder, if that cylinder which is subjected to internal fluid pressure, the stresses are induced in the cylindrical shell. Those stresses are hoop stresses, also known as circumferential stresses, longitudinal stress and radial stress. The direction of the hoop stress is along the circumference. So these hoop stresses are developed along the circumference of the cylinder, and the longitudinal stresses are developed along the longitudinal axis of the cylinder, and the radial stresses are developed along the normal to the thickness. So in case of thin cylinder, if it is subjected to an internal fluid pressure, the thickness of that cylindrical shell is very less. So in the situation, among these three stresses, the radial stress intensity value is negligible. But in case of thick cylinder, we are considered that radial stress also. But in case of thin cylinder, the thickness of that cylindrical shell is very less, so we are neglecting the radial stresses. Let us discuss about circumferential stress. How to derive the intensity of that circumferential stress when a thin cylindrical shell which is subjected to internal fluid pressure P. Consider thin cylinder of internal diameter D, thickness T and length L is subjected to an internal fluid pressure P. Due to radial pressure normal to the walls, cylinder tend to expand radially. There will be tensile or hoop stress, sigma H or hoop stress, which is set up in the circumferential direction, and the sigma L, nothing but longitudinal stress, which is developed along the longitudinal axis of the member. So before calculating of the intensity of hoop stress and longitudinal stress, the shells following some assumptions. So first assumption is the radial stress is small and it may be neglected. Already we have discussed the thickness of the cylindrical shell, thin cylindrical shell, is very less. So the intensity of that radial stress value is negligible. The next assumption is hoop and longitudinal stresses are constant across the thickness of shell, and the material is homogeneous and isotropic, and the stresses are within the proportionality limit. Based on these assumptions, we are calculating the hoop stress intensity and longitudinal stress intensity when the thin cylinders are subjected to internal fluid pressure P. Now, let us consider half portion of thin cylindrical shell. So here, When this thin cylindrical shell, which is subjected to an internal fluid pressure P, the hoop stresses are induced in the cylindrical portion. And those hoop stresses are the resisting stresses. These resisting stresses are developed the internal fluid pressure P. So always we are consider the equilibrium condition of the cylindrical shell. What is that equilibrium condition? The applied force, which is equal to the resisting force. What is the applied force? That applied force is nothing but pressured fluid force. How to calculate the pressure fluid force? So here, the applied force or the downward force, which is equal to the intensity of pressure into projected area. So here the intensity of pressure we are denoted with P, and the projected area is diameter of the cylinder into length of the cylinder. So the applied fluid pressure force, which is equal to intensity of pressure and projected area, that is equal to P into dl. And the total applied force, which is resisted by the cylindrical shells. So how to calculate that resisting force, resisting stress into that projected affected area? So what is the resisting stress here? Hoop stress. So sigma t into that affected area is 2t into l. For the equilibrium condition, we are consider that applied force, which is equal to the resisting force, then we equating 1 and 2 equation, then we get the intensity of hoop stress, that is PD by 2T. When a thin cylindrical shell, which is subjected to an internal fluid pressure, the intensity of the hoop stress is PD by 2T. When the hoop stress value exceeds their permissible value, the failure will be developed along the longitudinal direction. When the hoop stress value exceeds their permissible value, the failure or the cracks, which are developed along the longitudinal axis of the cylinder. And similarly, when the longitudinal stresses, which exceeds their permissible value, the failure will be developed along the circumferential direction. Let us discuss about longitudinal stress. How to calculate the intensity of that longitudinal stress? So here also same, we are consider equilibrium condition, that is applied force is equal to the resisting force. So here we are consider half of the cylindrical portion, and that portion which is affected by the pressure fluids P. When this half of the cylindrical portion is subjected to an internal fluid pressure P, the stresses develop along its circumference, that is longitudinal stresses sigma L, and the projected area is its cross-sectional area. So the cross section of the cylinder is circular section. So that cross sectional area or projected area, which is equal to pi by 4 into d square. Let sigma L is the longitudinal stress. So in this condition also, that applied force is equal to the resisting force for the equilibrium condition. What is that applied force? Pressure force. How to calculate the pressure force? Intensity of pressure into cross sectional area. That intensity of pressure is P, and the cross-sectional area is circular section, so the area is pi by 4 into d square. And the total applied force, which is resisted by the cylindrical portion or cylindrical shell, that resisting force is equal to resisting stress into affected area. That resisting stress is the longitudinal stress, and these stresses developed along the circumference, that is pi d into t. When you equate the 1 and 2 equations, then we get the longitudinal stress intensity, and that value is equal to pd by 4t. When the thin cylinders are subjected to internal fluid pressure, the longitudinal stress intensity is pd by 4t. So here, when you observe the equation of longitudinal stress and hoop stress, the hoop stress intensity is equal to PD by 2T, and the longitudinal stress intensity is equal to PD by 4T. So here, which stress intensity is maximum? Hoop stress intensity is maximum. So those are the major principal stress in thin cylinders if it is subjected to internal fluid pressure. When These thin cylinders are subjected to hoop and longitudinal stresses. The maximum shear stresses are induced in that cylindrical shell. So from the Mohs circle, that radius of the Mohs circle, which represent the maximum shear stress, and that equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2, where sigma 1 is the major principal stress, sigma 2 is the minor principal stress. So here the major principal stress is hoop stress and the minor stress is longitudinal stress. When you substitute those values in that equation, then we get the maximum shear stress intensity, and which is equal to PD by 80. So due to this internal stresses, hoop and longitudinal stresses, the volume of the cylinder may be changes. So that volume change is due to the change in diameter of the cylinder, change in length of the cylinder. So how to calculate the change in diameter due to that internal stress, hoop and longitudinal stress? How to calculate the change in length because of internal stress like hoop and longitudinal stresses? Let us discuss about circumferential strain and a longitudinal strain. So the strain is nothing but what? Change in length by, so change in dimensions by virginal dimensions. So here we are calculate the circumferential strain. Circumferential strain means change in diameter by virginal diameter. From the Hooke's law, what is that Hooke's law? Stress is directly proportional to strain within the proportionality limit. So here, based on that Hooke's law equations, for to calculate the strain in a particular direction, you have to consider stress in that direction and stress in the opposite direction. So here the circumferential strain is equal to stress, circumferential stress by Young's modulus minus Poisson's ratio into longitudinal stress by Young's modulus. So if you substitute the intensity of circumferential stress and the longitudinal stress, then we get the circumferential strain. Similarly, longitudinal strain also. So longitudinal strain is nothing but change in length by virginal length. So based on that Hooke's law equations, for to calculate the strain in longitudinal direction, you have to consider the strain in that direction and strain in the opposite direction. What is the strain in that direction? Stress in that direction by Young's modulus, that is sigma L by E, minus Poisson's ratio into strain in the opposite direction, that is sigma C by E. If you substitute the intensity of the longitudinal stress and the circumferential stress values in that equation, then we get the longitudinal strain value. So the volume change, or the volume change in the thin cylinder, is nothing but change in all directions, x direction, y direction and z direction. So what are the dimensions in x direction? The diameter of the cylinder. And along the y direction also, the diameter of the cylinder. And along the z direction, the length of the cylinder. So the volume change, which is equal to 2 times of its change in diameter plus change in length. So if you substitute the values in that equation, the strain values in that equation, then we get the volume change of the thin cylinder due to an internal stresses like hoop and longitudinal stress. So in this lecture, we are discussed about stress intensities. If a thin cylinder is subjected to internal fluid pressure, what are the stresses are induced in the cylinder? What are the stresses? Hoop and longitudinal stress. And the radial intensity, radial stress intensity is negligible because the thickness of the cylindrical shell is less, so the radial stress intensity is negligible. And we are also discussed about change in volume of the cylinder due to an internal fluid pressure. Thank you.